Oh.
So the gate of Moria swung open, and all of us went in. But before we could go further, a terrible tentacled creature attacked from the water behind us. It tried its utmost to eat Mr. Frodo, but Strider fought it off. And then there was a mighty crashing behind us as we ran into the mines.
But one choice. We must face the long dark of Moria.
Soon, Master Elf, you will enjoy the fabled hospitality of the dwarves. Roaring fires, malt beer, red meat off the bone.
Stay a moment. Goblins!
We must find my cousin Balin. He will explain this.
As we made our way through the ancient cavern, part of the ceiling fell to the ground with a tremendous crash. After that, we all watched for rockfalls as we traveled deeper into Moria.
Spiders! Use fire, Aragorn! Fire!
Balin would never let the mines fall into such a state.
We reached the great mine workings of Moria, but the dwarves who had built them were nowhere to be seen. Instead, goblins lurked in every corner, watching for unwanted guests.
I see a scout.
Shoot it! Before it calls for help!
Archers!
Goblins!
see a scout.
Shoot it! Before it calls for help!
It's too dark, even for elf eyes.
Use your torch, Aragorn. There must be something to light around here somewhere.
The wealth of Moria was not in gold or jewels, but Mithra.
The boy called Estel was not told his true name, Aragorn, until he was 20 years old and had come of age. That was when he was given the shards of Narsil, the broken sword that had belonged to his ancestor, Elendil.
Thank you.
I see a scout.
Shoot it! Before it calls for help!
We could go no further while the bridge was raised, but the wheels to lower it were on the other side of a deep chasm. Aragorn would need a steady hand to hit them with his bow.
Use flame arrows, Aragorn!
Hey, that'll do it! Balin must have raised the bridges to stop the goblins crossing.
Let's hope it worked.
Find the arrows!
Ah!
Carefully. No creature would leave their young alone.
Spider can scare me.
Come on.
Bilbo had a shirt of Mithril rings that Thorin gave me. I never told him, but its worth was greater than the value of the Shire.
Eager to find his cousin, Gimli rushed forwards to lower the bridge, but a group of mean-looking orcs stood guard nearby. We had to keep them away from Gimli while he turned the wheel. Soon after learning his true name, Aragorn met Elrond's daughter Arwen in Rivendell, and he fell in love with her at once. Before then, she had lived with her mother's kin in Lothlorien, so he had never laid eyes upon her.
We are now deep under the Misty Mountains.
In the dark, it wasn't clear which way we should go next. Gandalf needed more light to pick the right path. In the firelight, Gandalf could see runes on the right-hand door.
Is that where?
Aragorn caught sight of a strange, pale creature lurking in the dark. It was Gollum. He'd been following us through the mines, drawn by the power of the ring he had once carried.
the great realm and dwarf city of Dwarrowdelph.
Now there's an eye-opener and no mistake.
This, my friend, is the home of my cousin Balin.
Cave wolves. They have our scent.
And they are hungry for dwarf.
Thank you.
Quick, Aragorn! Smash the door!
The door to the Chamber of Records was open. Within, Gimli hoped he would discover the fate of his cousin Balin.
Hail, Aragorn.
Here lies Balin, son of Hundin, lord of Moria. He is dead then.
Oh, no.
It's as I feared.
Orcs!
Yet in Moria who still draws breath.
Ugh!
shall they scuttle from their holes! We must stop them!
Cave troll.
Getting the hang of this. Frodo!
We must move on. We cannot linger.
Beyond any of you.
beast away from me while I open the gate!
The walls cannot hold it.
The door creaked open just as all hope seemed lost, and we fled from the Balrog once more.
The door! You mind the Balrog!
Creaked open just as all hope seemed lost, and we fled from the Balrog once more.
Get out of here! Get out!
We cannot fight it. The Balrog is too strong.
Below us, a crumbling staircase led to the Bridge of Khazad-dûm. The eastern gate of Moria was almost in sight, but even here, goblins lay in wait. I had ever felt sadder than the moment we thought Gandalf was lost.
But it was all right, wasn't it? Gandalf came back later.
Well, you're quite right, Frodo. We did see him again. But he wasn't quite the same.
Oh.